Hi, guys. I'm glad all my friends are here this morning. Thank you for joining me. There was a magnitude 2.1 earthquake there in Pennsylvania last night, 10:47 p.m. local time. 155 people reportedly felt it and reported to USGS Did You Feel It webpage. Yesterday, I noticed there was a magnitude 1.5 earthquake, 4.8 kilometers in depth, at 2:06 a.m. local time. And when I saw this earthquake yesterday, I had to think about the one they had there that did so much damage in Washington 10 years ago. That happened in the afternoon of August 23rd, 2011. And I wondered how long it would be before they have another major earthquake there on the East Coast. This 1.5 was 4.8 kilometers in depth, which was 2.8 miles below sea level, and all earthquakes are measured from sea level. I had thought about doing a report on this earthquake because, as you know, there is a 20% chance of being a foreshock for a much larger earthquake. But I didn't. I got busy with other things. I did share it on Twitter and asked if anybody felt it, and I got no responses. It had an intensity level of 4, meaning it was a very light earthquake. And down over here, you can see, Philadelphia. And then today there was the magnitude 2.1, which 155 people said they felt, 2.9 kilometers in depth. It was much shallower. So that would be about 1.8 miles below sea level. Yep, it was shallower. Like I said, it happened at 10:47 p.m. local time last night. Intensity level of 4, which means it would have been considered a light earthquake. And here's the location map of those reports. Again, down here by Philadelphia, up here by Allentown. And what's that? Pottsville, it looks like. Valley View. Bristol, New Hollow, Parksburg. You know, that earthquake that they had 10 years ago was a small earthquake in a sense of what could happen. It was a magnitude 5.8. It is considered to be one of the largest earthquakes to ever strike the East Coast, causing an estimated $200 million to $300 million in damage. That 5.8 was felt from Florida to southern Canada and as far west as the Mississippi River Valley. It is also considered the most damaging earthquake to strike the eastern United States since a magnitude 7.0 earthquake near Charleston, South Carolina in 1886. I've covered a lot of these earthquakes that have been recently happening. They're what is considered intercontinental earthquakes, and they really don't understand the mechanism of why they're happening. But I believe that because of the Atlantic Ocean widening, we got movement of the continent slowly moving west. You can see some of the earthquakes that I put down here and I have reported about. I talked about the earthquakes that have occurred near the nuclear power plants in my past videos. And about the mountain building that's going on. You know, many of the people that felt that earthquake 10 years ago were very little then. So they're probably in their early 20s now and probably are not earthquake prepared. They probably really don't remember what happened with that earthquake, the damage and the shaking that happened, etc. Here's that 5.8, the location of that 5.8 back in 2011. And then up to the north is where today's earthquakes have occurred. Let me zoom into that area. There's some homes here and there's some businesses. But being that late at night, people might have been in bed. I don't know. Might have been getting ready for bed, but the businesses more likely were closed. The shaking probably lasted about 1 to 2 seconds, and for an intensity level of 4, means during the day would be felt indoor by many, outdoors, you know, just a few. At night, if you were sleeping, you would have been woken maybe. Dishes, windows, doors disturbed, walls made creaking sounds, sensation. Like a heavy truck striking a building. And if you were outside, you might have noticed automobiles rocking. Most of this younger generation don't worry about keeping up with the Joneses. They just want to live day to day and enjoy their life. They're probably not even preppers. They're probably not even prepared for any sort of catastrophe, be it a hurricane, earthquakes, flooding, things like that. But they should be prepared. You just don't know when the next large earthquake's going to happen. So, what are your thoughts? Please put those comments down below. Thank you for watching. Thank you very much for your support. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.